So I'm here at in São Paulo, one of the last projects I looked at. Here I'm in Bella Vista, Avenida Brigadeiro Luis Antonio, number 903 is going to be the address here. And there used to be a parking lot there, and they're going to construct a building there. That way, by foot, you can get to Avenida Paulista. Bella Vista is a really nice area in São Paulo, a little outside of the historic center. And you can walk to the Japanese Liberdade neighborhood from here, and also to the historic center. And like I said, this used to be a parking lot. Right here, there's not that many tall buildings right around here. So even if you get like a medium height here, you'll get a pretty nice view around the city here. There's actually a couple of theaters here. Here's one right across the street. There's also, like, you can see the bus stop is right there for going to Paulista. And over there is another theater, actually. So this is a pretty nice place. There's not homeless people outside living here, as there is somewhere in the, some places in the center. So this is really, really a good location. This project has 121 units. There's going to be one bedroom apartment, two bedroom apartments, only a few of those, and then studio apartments. But mostly it's going to be one bedroom apartment. I'll show you what an apartment like that could look like a little bit later. Then there's going to be some common areas as well. I'll go through them with you also in a while, and then I'll have a look around the neighborhood with you as well, to see what kind of shops are here and nearby. So let's try and go inside here. So it's actually filled up with people today, and this is actually before the actual start date of the sale. So the people are still here already. Looking at these apartments is because they're very affordable. Here you can see some of the plans. I'll show you those to you later as well in a better format. Out here in the courtyard, a lot of people on their phones talking to real estate agents. And in here, and that's the reason why I came today, they just finished the decoration. That could be why there's a lot of people here as well. So here's a demo behind that door of a 25 square meter apartment. So, and that gives a good idea of what it could look like when this building is done. They usually put up a map like this over the city and put the building where it's going to be, so you can see other landmarks and metro stations close by here in this area. This terrain, I think, is 703 square meters. And like you can see, the surrounding buildings are not that tall. So if you get just to the fifth or sixth floor in this building, you'll get a nice view as well. And here on the ground floor is going to be all the common areas. There's going to be a cafe there. They're going to sell that off. And then there's going to be a guard. Just taking you around the area so you can see what kind of area it is. There's an extra supermarket that's a cheap chain. And they have these small, like, two-storage buildings here with the small romantic balconies. It's really nice and traditional. And then there's a lot of local shops here. This is a small supermarket. There's another one. So there's a lot of options for shopping, actually, here. I think this is maybe another one. This is a pharmacy. And then there's a butcher right here, and meat is pretty cheap here. It's either Brazilian meat or it could be from Argentina. A filet mignon is 39, that's about $7.3, I think, for a kilo. So meat, you can get some really good meat here, cheap. And that goes for the restaurants as well, actually. I think we're passing one later. I'll show you. There's an organic greengrocer over there on the other side, which is not that common here to find organic goods on the market. So that's pretty good that you have that right next to you. There's another mixed markets with some electronics as well. And these newspaper stands, they are here outside. You can buy something to read in, cigarettes, charge your credits on your phone or your Metro card, and buy snacks, all kinds of stuff like that. And yeah, that on the other side is an old church. Here on the corner is a small eatery. 16 and a half reais for a meal, 5 different types of meat to choose from. Then you get rice, beans, french fries, salad, and that's about $3.1 for that. So that's pretty cheap. And right down there, the street, 70 meters, is the apartment. So right now I'm inside the decoration. As you can see here, there's some closets here. There's an eating place for 4 people, it looks like. There's some small chairs on the other side, a sofa, a window, a small coffee table there, and then there are these wardrobes or whatever, if you want them open or closed. You can have this handmade on measurements here. It's not that expensive in Brazil. Yeah, they have these two small chairs there. And then there's a fridge and a small tea kitchen here with a stove. There's 4 stove tops. Usually they just have 2, so this is pretty nice, a full oven as well, and some cabinets. All of these cabinets is not gonna be here. Actually, the tabletop is gonna be here, and like the tabletop and the sink and the faucet is gonna be here. But it might not look like this. It might be a cheaper brand because they, of course, chose something that is supposed to look impressive. Here they had a designer. These stones will be here. It'll not be these stones. The floor won't be here. You need to put that in. So you'll receive the apartment 90% done. But they have companies who can do the rest for you. You just choose what materials you want, because that's very individual for people. So you can choose exactly the colors, the stones you want to use, and they'll put it in for you, or you can contract someone to do it for you and get it a little cheaper. But they have package deals for that. So this floor won't be there, you'll need to put that in. The fridge also won't be here, the aircon won't be here, so you need to put in stuff like that. Now let's see here what they did. This is 25 square meters, and they put in a glass wall between the bedroom and the living room here because it makes it look bigger. And as you can see, there's some wardrobes in there with mirrors on them. I'll show you when I go in there a little later. So you could choose if you want this glass wall or a normal wall and a door, which most people would choose. And or you can keep it a full open space if you want that. Here in the bedroom, they did something really nice. They put the wardrobe at the end and then put from floor to ceiling mirrors on it. So it doesn't seem cramped at all when you're in here. It feels a lot bigger because of those mirrors. So that's a very nice detail, and you probably want to do that as well. I know I want to do it with my apartment, at least on one wall, because it just makes those 25 square meters look a lot bigger than they actually are. So yeah, and I'll show you the common areas in just a second, what you'll have outside of this apartment in the building that you can use. There's actually a lot of interesting common areas there, so you don't have to spend your time in the small apartment all the time. But this is your private space. These buildings have less common areas than some of the other buildings I've seen looking at. This one doesn't have a pool, for example. It doesn't have a gym, which most of the new buildings have, but then the price is also higher. Here it's more basic, I would say, but then you get a really nice price. This is the first decoration. I saw one of these plaques actually describing that you won't get it exactly like this. You will have to put in the details yourself to make the last 10% of the apartment, but it's fairly cheap. For I think 30,000, 35,000 reais, you can do a nice reform in here. it might not be with these luxury materials, but you can pay more money and get nicer stuff as well. But yeah, for 35,000, I think you can make a pretty good reform, including all the furniture and the aircon and stuff like that. So let's have a look at the decoration. Oh, let's have a look at the common areas. So yeah, before we go into the common areas, I just wanted to show you this plaque of the construction company Magic JC, who is gonna build this building. You can see they already made 7 other projects here in this bigger project where they construct several affordable buildings here in São Paulo called Bem Viver. And this is one of those projects where they're usually around 200,000 reais for this apartment, and that's a really cheap square meter price for a new apartment. So they made 12,000 units, 12,000 apartments in, I think they made more than 120 buildings during these 47 years, it says here. So that's an old company here that's constructed a lot of buildings. I don't like to look at the ones who are doing their first building or just has done maybe 2 or 3 or something like that. But these people, you can find a lot of stuff on them on the internet, so you can see if they're a good or bad constructor. But they probably are, otherwise they wouldn't still be in business after 47 years. But you should also always look into that. So let's have a look at the common areas here. This is the first one. This is the what do you call it? Gourmet party room, I think they call it. It has a bar here in the wall, so there's a small bar and there's windows all the way around. You can sit inside, and this is connected to a social area outside where you can do a barbecue as well. So you can fit a pretty nice party in here, and you'll just play for the cleaning. This is the laundromat on the 12th floor, and this is three washers, 3 dryers. You can dry your clothes here and sit outside here and wait for your clothes to be done, or you can just leave. You know, it's nobody's gonna take it in this building. Here is the co-working, as they call it. I would call it more like an office. You can, it's mostly for meetings and presentations. This is one of the smaller ones. At least this one has windows all the way around, so there's some light coming in, and you can open the doors if it's hot. And you can sit maybe eight people in a meeting here or something like that. But if you needed to have something bigger than that, then you'd need another place. But this is nice to have in your building. And you can book this also privately for some hours if you have like a private meeting. Or you can go here and work while there could be other people here. And yeah, this is the outside play area for the kids. So there's some green areas here with some grass, and then they have some monkey bars and stuff like that. They actually they have in the material for this building that this should be the outdoor urban gym, I think they're calling it. I wouldn't call this a gym. Well, this is a playground for kids, but you can do some exercises in the monkey bars or something like that, but it's not really a gym, is it? But it's nice. You can, if you had a party there, the kids could play outside and you could watch them through the windows. This is from the front where they have the commercial space. They're gonna sell this store. It could be a cafe, it could be a clothing store as well. They're gonna design it to whoever wants to buy it. And next to it is a small parking, but that is just a disabled parking space. It's not for everyone, so you'll have to park in the street here if you had a car. This is the outdoor common areas right next to the this gourmet party room, and you could have a barbecue outside. There's a barbecue here, so you have a lot of room to have a small party here if you want to, or just hang out when you're home outside. And yeah, this is a bit further apart, so there's something covered, and then there's an open space. So this is the first plan for the decorations. This is actually the decoration I showed you earlier. This is the 24 point something, almost 25 square meters, where there's a separate bedroom. You can see here there's a proper wall, and there's a door from facing the kitchen in this one. But there are other apartments here as well, other sizes. Let's have a look at them. This is a studio apartment, but actually this has a form of a studio. It's more rectangular, but they made something really nice with that folding door here, so you can get your private bedroom as well. And then you can open it up, and maybe some would choose to have a sofa bed there where the bed is, because then they can convert it into a sofa, have four seatings for dinner, and then they can have a sofa as well during the day. And the TV is right there by the bed as well, I see. So this could be some kind of convertible apartment. This is pretty nice as well, this design, I think. And this is another one bedroom apartment, but this is bigger. This actually has a fixed place with a sofa in it, as you can see. So this is a bigger size. And here they have the two bedroom apartment. They only have a few of these in the buildings, in this building, because they'll be the most expensive ones. But there's a family with maybe a kid. This would be perfect. And there's a little private workspace as well here inside the apartment. And this is the terrain outside, where you can see everything. You can see the parking lot there. Yes, it is for disabled. And you can see all the common areas there at the bottom. And all of the common areas here at the bottom. There's nothing rooftop here, and that's just the laundromat on the 12th floor, and that's pretty much it.